Hello, a magnificent reception here tonight for the UK champion Alex Higgins, and confirming once again, as if confirmation were needed, that he is the biggest crowd puller and crowd pleaser in snooker. As so often in the past, a sell-out crowd assembled at the Wembley Conference Centre, 2,700 people filling the largest snooker arena in Britain to see the first appearance in the 1984 Masters of the man they call the Hurricane in his match against Doug Mountjoy. And there is Mountjoy, a difficult situation then for him amid all this support for Higgins, but what a scalp it would be for the Welshman if he could pull this one off. Okay, on to the first frame in the best of nine, Higgins to break, and the commentators are Willie Thorne and Ted Lowe.
Alex Higgins breaks off for the first of our nine frames in this first round match. His opponent from Wales, Doug Mountjoy. Cue ball right in the middle of the pack. Mountjoy got to the semi-finals in this tournament last year, defeated by his fellow countryman Ray Reardon.
Judge Morgan
won the event in 1977, the first time he came into the tournament. Terrific player from Wales. Alex Higgins, who has perhaps the most extraordinary record in this Benson Hedges tournament. He's won it twice. Semi-finalist on two occasions, runner-up twice, always been thereabouts. Where's this red coming to? Slows up. Alex can't see it. He's played a safety stroke, but there is one there, red there, over the top pocket.
One.
Doug now has the problem of getting at the black.
Foul, one. Mountjoy, seven.
In fact, the cue ball didn't reach the black. And therefore, as you see, the slight distance between the two balls cost him 7 points. But Higgins is raring to go. Has a habit in the last 12 months of getting that cue ball cleaned. Gives him chance of looking around the table just to see where the rest of the balls are.
I think it must be said also, Ted, that Alex is without doubt one of the best sportsmen in the game. What actually happened then that Alex accidentally leaned on the red that we see in between the blue and green, and the true sportsman that he admitted it without to the referee seeing it.
Eight. Nine.
And that at the moment puts Mountjoy 1 point ahead. Very early stages of this first frame, the first of nine in this first round match. Cut himself right under the side cushion, shakes his head there. Alex hasn't got too much to go at here, will he? It's a difficult one for him.
I think he might be attempting the pot. Actually, Chad is only Reddy can really see. He did have a little bit of a go at that one. It's just a matter of more luck than judgment, I think, where the red's going to finish. I'm not sure whether Doug can see that one. It's also quite amazing that first frame of any nine-frame match or any match at all, it's always very difficult to get the pace of the table, and Doug, we've seen in his last two visits, the table has lost position slightly.
Nine, 16, 17.
Doug just has the loose red at the side of the pack now, and I think after the next red he'll have to obviously think in terms of playing either off the blue or the black to split the remaining six reds. I think we'll see Doug actually playing into the pink here, which I'm sure will maneuver the six threads in his favour.
No,
they've not come out too favourably for him. He's 39 points ahead. For safety.
Not only has Doug played the white very safe, it's interesting to note also he's pushed to red on the side cushion, obviously leading by 39 points. Alex will at one time need the red, and it's a very good point to notice that Doug has put a red out of the game at the moment.
Good man, Joy, 52, Alex Higgins, 13.
Another good one from Mountjoy. Quite happy with his situation as he sits down there with his cigarette. Brilliant, of course, by Higgins.
One, Alex Higgins.
He's just got 1 point out of it. The Welshman full of confidence here.
Eight. Nine.
Now 54 points in front with only 51 points left on the
16.
Table. Alex, just wondering what's happened to this first frame. It's gone away from him, I'm afraid. And Doug moves that difficult last stroke.
25.
That puts him 68 points in front with only 35 possible points on the table.
30. Forty.
And they're all there for him. So the Welshman, Doug Mountjoy, cleaning up now in this first of our nine-frame first-round match. Showing Alex Higgins how to do it, and Alex sits there, unable to do anything about it at all.
47. 52. Good Mountjoy.
Mountjoy then very happy with a 52 break. Consolidating the first of our nine frames. Alex plays a trick shot, but concedes the frame, and so the first frame goes to Welshman Doug Mountjoy.
That was comprehensive enough for Mountjoy, but Higgins leveled it in the next frame with a break of 55, and we can rejoin it in frame number three right at the start, and it's Higgins to play.
One.
A good long red from Alex Higgins to start the third frame. Not too easy for a colour, and the cue ball on the side cushion there, and he wants to get back up the table for the reds.
One, Alex Higgins.
Obviously just played safe. Joy won the first frame, should have won the second, but was overcome by the potting of Alex Higgins. And my word, I wonder what he's done here. Even these great stars in the Masters can miss the easy ones.
I'm not too sure whether the black or pot, Ted, but it would be a serious mistake if the black pots as well.
One.
Obviously it does, and now Doug's in with a great chance.
Seventeen. Twenty-four. Thirty-three.
Some brilliant potting here by the Welshman.
Forty-one. Forty-two. 48.56. 57.
Proven to be a very good match, Ted, in each of the three frames we've played now. We've had
64.
Breaks over 50 in each frame, and Doug has a very good chance here of making the highest break so far.
65.
5 reds to go.
72. 73.
Jimmy White has the highest break so far in this tournament, an 84.
78. 79.
And what a costly mistake he made.
86.
86, the highest so far, which is claiming the £1,000 highest break prize.
87.
I think what will please Doug more than anything, Ted, is the way he's made the break. He's now on 87 with a possible blue to make 92, and he's never once been out of position. Absolutely super break so far.
92. 93.
And he now has the problem of that last red.
He's actually played a very good red there. Ted has an angle to either move the red or drop behind it. He played a super red. Trying to drop behind it. Not quite as hard as he'd like, but that is a central break, which is fabulous.
Doug Mountjoy then makes the first century break of the Benson Hedges Masters 1984.
Well, Doug Mountjoy not had the best of results of late, but plenty of confidence there. The highest break of the tournament so far and a 2-1 lead. Well, there was one more frame before the interval. Mountjoy took an early lead with a break of 32. And we now find Higgins at the table and he's trailing by 32 points to 20.
1.
7.
7.
7. I think Doug's main concern here, Ted, is the red is very, very straight. And the problem is he not only wants to finish on the black or pink, but also needs an angle to be able to get back onto the two loose reds. If potting the red and just stunning it in, of course, he'll be playing the black in and out of balks. So he's going to have to try and either run through and get onto the black at the right angle or screw back and might even play the screw back for the pink. Looks like he's running through for the black.
8.
And he seems to have found the perfect angle. It was a very, very good shot.
15, 16, 22.
Now 41 points ahead with a possible 43 points on the table.
29.
I think actually what Doug was trying to do there is pot the pink with a terrific amount of right-hand side to hopefully kiss the two reds out, but played the shot the right pace, but unfortunately didn't have the side on to play the shot. But looks like he's played a terrific recovery shot.
29, Doug Mercer.
Off the top cushion. He wanted a terrific amount of left-hand side, and he gives 7 points away.
Not only has he given 7 points away, Ted, there's now 48 points in the game with only 43 on. A very costly error by Alex.
Doug Mountjoy, 68, Alex Higgins, 20. One.
Now Alex must take a big colour. He's already in trouble. The black helps.
8.
40 points behind, 35 points on the table.
8.
That's too easy.
Alex Higgins. Doug Mountjoy, 68. Alex Higgins, 28.
Alex would ideally like to keep the red on the table, Ted, but I'm not sure whether he can get the red safe anymore. He might have no trouble but to pot it.
One.
The only problem now, of course, with potting the last red is he now need two snookers on the colours.
Now 34 points behind, with just 27 Six. Points left on the table. Two snookers and all the balls to win by 1 point.
Six, Alex Higgins.
Alex has got the snooker there, Ted, but I'm sure he tried to hold the white behind the green as well. Not as hard a snooker as it would have been as if it had been behind the green.
Alex Higgins, 34, Doug Mountjoy, 68.
Once again, he asked for that cue ball to be clean, giving him chance to look around the table, what shot to play. Where can he place the balls?
Once again, Teddy will be trying to get the white, I think, behind the green. Not quite hard enough this time, but still has a snooker behind the blue. Of course, not so easy to hit this time. The ideal place he'd like to hit, I believe, is where the middle pocket is, unless he plays with a terrific amount of right-hand side off the top cushion, or he might even try another swerve.
Going for the swerve.
Well, six.
And it's a free ball.
Alex Higgins, free ball.
A completely different complexion on the frame now. 28 points in it, but Alex with a free ball, which means any ball he likes to pot will count 2 points.
Yes, Ted, what an amazing game this snooker is. 1 minute ago that Mountjoy was looking certain to go into the interval with a 3-1 lead. Still favourite to go into the interval with a 3-1 lead, but now gives Alex an opportunity that 2 minutes ago he never thought he'd have. Brown, of course, been worth two, and I think Doug will find himself in even more trouble after this shot.
Two, Alex Higgins.
And so the difference now, 26 points with a possible 27 points on the table. Colours out in the open.
I'm sure we see Alex having a go at this yellow, but doesn't have the ideal angle to be able to get onto the green. Very, very difficult pot. A Two. And we had the problem because he didn't have the angle on the yellow to play position for the green. Has not quite got on the green as he would have liked. I'm sure he'll be playing the white behind the brown and the green up the table, possibly behind the blue, pink and black.
Two, Alex Higgins. Mountjoy, 68, Alex Higgins, 44.
What a fighter this Alex Hurricane Higgins is. Only a few moments ago, he wanted two or three snookers. Now, in a situation where just three balls will win him the frame. Fantastic recovery then by the former world champion Alex Hurricane Higgins, who out of the depths of death comes back to make the match all square, two frames each.
Higgins, the master of the comeback. And that match coming very nicely to the boil now with Higgins level at 2-all. But Doug Mountjoy, the Welshman, still playing with plenty of confidence. Well, it's the best of 9 frames, the first of 5. Long way still to go. And we'll be back here on BBC Two with further coverage at 11:25. Join us then. Mountjoy against the Hurricane. BBC Two, 11:25. Welcome back to Wembley for the climax to the first round match we left earlier between Alex Higgins and Doug Mountjoy. Well, Higgins came out to a tremendous reception from the capacity crowd of nearly 3,000, but it was Mountjoy, playing very well indeed, who proceeded to take the first frame. Well, Higgins then levelled it, only for Mountjoy to regain the lead with a break of 100, that's the highest in the tournament so far, and he looked like going 3-1 ahead when Higgins needed snookers in the fourth frame, but somehow Higgins clawed his way back to square the match. So it's 2-all in the best of 9 as they start the fifth frame with Higgins there to break. Commentators Rex Williams and Jack Carnham.
So, 2 frames all and Alex Higgins breaks and lands tight on the bottom cushion. For the shot and not a great deal of damage.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. It would be very much appreciated by players and audience alike if you could refrain from shouting. Thank you.
And John Smiley asking for quiet from the audience. Well, difficult to say what Doug was playing there, but my word, he's set Alex up with a nice chance here.
Yes, well, he played the plant, Jack, but it certainly was a risky one.
One.
And this is certainly a good chance for Alex.
Sixteen. 17.
Alex will want to get the red away from the back of the black spot. This makes it that little bit more difficult to have a red lying there to get position.
24.
Well, Alex asking for the cue ball to be cleaned, and what better start can any player have than to get off so early in the frame to a nice easy start, and of course that helps to build up the confidence in oneself. Gradually, Alex has cleared all the open reds. Just a fraction too far on that.
48. Alex.
2,800 people are watching this match tonight.
Loose safety shot there from Doug, and I think a red will just clip into the centre pocket. And apart from the red into the centre, also a red will now go into the other corner pocket.
Eight. 9.
A little bit unlucky there, Alex, and this is certainly a dangerous shot if you play his position on this black. Won't want to take any risks with the 57-point lead and the 7 reds left on the table. No point in throwing the lead away. Sensible choice of shot.
Certainly found a good one there. And
one.
What a good time to find such a shot when previously Doug had played a very subtle shot there to open the reds and leave Alex what seemed to be safe. But he's reversed the situation completely now in his own favour.
Five. Alex Higgins, 4.
Well, that's unlucky because it was a good pot there from Alex, but that means that Alex is now 58 points in front and possible 67 on the table.
Enjoy
5
four.
Reds left.
Alex Higgins, 62.
Nothing easy for Doug Mountjoy from this position. A good try there from Doug, but just trapped in the jaws. But I don't think Alex can quite get at it. Looks to be playing a cannon off the one red onto the other, and this is a dangerous shot. So that pink means that Doug Manjo now needs snookers.
Seven. Eight. Twelve. 18.
And Alex, having of course won the frame, is now just cleaning up, playing with complete freedom. And very nice too to be able to build your confidence for the next one.
23.
And Alex certainly hurrying around the table, getting into the mood, and this could
37
prove to be rather dangerous for Doug for the ensuing frames.
42.
And beautiful, delightful play by Alex to take a lead of 3 frames to 2.
That frame lasting just 15 minutes and those breaks of 48 and 55 giving Higgins the lead for the first time in the match at 3-2. This is frame 6 with Doug Mountjoy to break.
Well, that really was quite a bad break by Doug, but could possibly have got away with it. This is a possible pot, but not easy. And so we continue from the previous frame.
What?
Alex feeling in the mood where he's raring to go.
Hasn't quite got the desired position there. The red is going into the bunch of reds this time.
Five, Alex Higgins.
Could have been a lot worse. Don't think that he's left anything here for Doug.
Certainly a risky shot he played there. I would have thought safety would have been the better judgment there. I mean, again, he's given Alex a chance to take this red into the right-hand corner, and if he can get on a colour, my word, these reds are quite open.
Eight. 8. Nine. 16.
Well, that was a very good opening red from Alex, and controlled the cue ball beautifully. And he looks to be playing very well at the moment, and the balls are split 24. Beautifully. And I know 25. It's early days at the moment, but certainly think he could make it 4-2 here.
Doug rather in pensive mood, knowing the task that's ahead of him when this fella's buzzing.
32.
Well, he's rather made a mess of that, Alex.
In a flash, he's 37 points ahead. Lovely shot, regardless of the white going in. That's really hard luck, but played the pot and the safety together, and a little unfortunate there. Doug rather tentative there in his approach, and given a possible chance here. John Smythe just cleaning the cue ball. Red into the middle.
8.
Screwing back as he did it for the black made that doubly difficult.
15.
Was 15, quite a long way out, and that kiss into the pack has given Doug the opportunity that he should try and take advantage
of. Well, in fact, Jack, I think that Alex is probably a little bit fortunate there, because I don't think there's anything easy here for Doug. The alternatives that he's got are quite tricky shots. This red in the centre that he's taking is a little bit of a tricky shot to pot and control position. It's a good pot, but
one.
Still nothing easy. He's got the pink into the centre, but certainly far from easy. Looks more like it. Two good shots there from Doug. And now nicely in position. Still 40 points behind, so there's a fair bit of pressure here on Doug Mountjoy.
Quite a long way out there, and I would dare to suggest that he totally mistimed that shot, and that's entirely due to the excellent play and the pressure that Alex is putting on him.
One.
So Alex now in a position to really...
Eight.
Put an end to this frame, leading by 48 points.
Nine. Sixteen.
So Doug well into snookers now, so the frame is virtually over.
Nineteen.
And that just a little short. I think he wanted that back into the right-hand corner pocket, but this is a tricky one into the left-hand corner. 34. For the green brown. Only problem, the blue.
36. Thirty-nine. 43.
So I'm sure that Doug nods his head and says, yes, that's it. And Alex goes into a 4-2 lead.
Well, just 13 and a half minutes that one lasted. Higgins really flying. And Mountjoy, who began so well, now just one frame from defeat. This is the next frame with Higgins at the table, and he leads by 20 points to 11.
And he certainly looked in good form this evening.
Seven.
Almost 2,800 people here at the Wembley Conference Centre. And they've been treated to some very good snooker.
14, 15.
So 30 points the lead. Just one red now, and a colour will put Doug into real bother.
22.
Well, the pace kept that out of the pocket.
22.
So 31 points the lead now. 27 on the table, which means that Doug wants one snooker to draw.
Alex Higgins, 42.
And two to win.
Well, Jack, I feel that Alex should have made sure of the pink there. He really had a whack at it, trying to get onto the yellow, and feeling that he's got this match won, but just one snooker required. It's not really sensible to take any undue risks, and Alex could have made it absolutely certain there.
Two, Doug Mountjoy. Doug Mountjoy, 13, Alex Higgins, 42.
That. Yeah, very thin tickle he got on the green there.
Three.
it's just a little bit of the green showing. Almost pottable into the left-hand corner pocket.
This is a fair chance here for Doug. He needs a snooker, but he can pot the green and position himself in such a way to possibly get a snooker behind the pink.
Three. Seven.
And that looks pretty good, Rex. If he gets the weight of this right, he can drop nicely behind that pink. Yes, that's a beauty. So just 22 points behind and 18 on the table. Of course, a snooker now would be worth 5 points, so he could win by one.
Well, Jack, Alex can certainly regret the way that he played that pink early on when he could have wrapped the game up now, because that means that Doug can win by 1 point, 17 points behind, a possible 18 on the table, and that is the result of playing the game in a very careless manner, and he'll certainly be thinking about that. Alex has had the game won once and now having to win it all over again.
And a chance here. This is quite potable. And come around the table for the pink. And a nice kiss on this pink would do him really proud. And that's not too bad. Right-hand corner pocket would bring him up for the black. Oh, bad.
Five, Doug Mountjoy.
Alex considers himself very lucky to get away with this now.
Well, Alex asking for the cue ball to be cleaned, and not a difficult pot, but nevertheless, there's a little amount of pressure here. It's a long way away. So in goes the pink, and Alex takes the match by 5-2. Very good performance by Alex, played quite well.
And Higgins goes through to meet Tony Knowles in the quarterfinals. We'll be back with three more programmes tomorrow, the first of them at 3 o'clock tomorrow afternoon. We started the day talking about the two great natural talents of snooker, Jimmy White and Alex Higgins. Tonight, they're